Hello, there, Meter Beats. Michelle Marie Delaney, and I'm Ian Finster. And we're here today because we wanted to talk to you together. Yesterday, I did an excellent video for Cup-A-Cab, and I think he really, or she really appreciated it a lot. And today, me and Michelle are going to talk about transitioning, as far as we understand, and of course, gender. There's at least, according to several scientists, there's at least 69 classifications of gender. But the problem is that they're going by three things. The way the person perceived to be, their biological condition, and the sexual preferences. You know what I think about that? Look, I think that's kind of muddying the water quite a bit more than we really need to. Because of the fact is that you're combining gender and sex together. You know, I kind of agree with you. I think it's like, okay, does it really matter? I mean, if a person is a male, but he acts feminine, and he has an attraction for a woman, you would say, okay, he's a straight man with female gender. Right. And that's kind of strange enough, right? The first question is, some people keep saying that gender is innate. Mm-hmm. Some are saying is the seed of it is innate, but it's the social and cultural aspects that make it grow into what it is. Okay, so you're talking about something like nature versus nurture. Yes. Okay, and then, of course, I realized that, and then, of course, somebody's going to always ask this question is, where did the seed come from? Okay, let's talk about the seed first. That's related to your firmware. Okay, I'm going to use computer terminology here because it's just like the firmware in a device, okay? If, in my BlackBerry, okay, the company puts firmware in this, okay, and the firmware is what provides the instructions how this device is to handle everyday things from typing to showing things on the screen. Well, your identity, that is your soul, is firmware, and it comes from all, Almighty Mother and Father God, okay? Almighty Yahweh and Mother Asna, okay? And the firmware is, it was created when you were created, your soul was created by Almighty Yahweh and Mother Asna in the beginning, right? When you come to Earth, every soul, for the most part, is male and female. Now, please understand, me and Lumi have talked about this. We kicked this car on the curb so many times. It's probably one of the most popular dialogues you've ever had. Yeah. You know, that question is do souls sometimes try to come back to Earth as other sexes? Right. And we have confirmed through Mother Asna and talking to Father Yahweh, we have confirmed that it does happen that all souls will, at least in their life charts, will choose to be either a boy or a girl, man or a woman, or hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite, which is challenging enough because, and that's something else we need to talk about, is how you had grown comfortable in your own skin as a hermaphrodite. Well, my situation's different because I've got you.
Right.
You are a masculine soul.
Yes.
I'm a feminine soul.
Yes.
This body's got both.
Yes.
So we share a body that's designed for perfectly compatible for two souls, the end of the yin and the yang, right? So that means, like, okay, so, I'm going to try to get it simple here. The whole point is that transgender is actually kind of interesting, because that's, we talked about the copycat situation. You talked about it on camera. I talked to you about it off camera. What I find fascinating when we talk about gender is that there's so much confusion. Everybody confuses it with biological sex. And like you said, they're different. They're separate. They're completely separate. You can be a male and be very effeminate. You can be a female and be very masculine. Or you may choose to be kind of neutral. Right. And that's where it gets fun. I don't really, never heard of a person's gender being truly neutral. Because there's always going to be something of the person's gender that's going to show up. Some piece of the background. Either in the way they talk to mannerisms or speech, right? It's going to happen. Yeah, it's going to happen. It's like, you may try to be like Mr. Spock in Star Trek and say, I have no gender, I do not pick a gender. But then again, in some of your subtle things you do, your gender, your true gender will show up. You may be able to suppress it for the most part, but it will show up. But then there are some people who are very fluid and their gender can flop. Not quite drastically like a balance scale. Not going whoop this way and then whoop this way. It doesn't happen that much. No, it's usually more like a slight, like I mentioned with the balance scale. It's usually like a slight shift up and down. So, you know, let me get into the gender dysphoria. What is the best solution for gender dysphoria? Well, you know, science is constantly trying to say is, it's just like the intro to the $6 million man. We have the technology, we can rebuild him. Right. But unfortunately, it doesn't always work because of a lot of reasons. Take a look what's going on with Caitlyn Jenner. Caitlyn Jenner is now kind of saying is, I heard this, I don't really can't confirm the source. It's said that Caitlyn says is she kind of would like to switch back to male. Wait, okay, so now, she, of course, being a famous runner and celebrity, went through, got all the surgical intervention, the hormone replacement therapy, everything. And now she wants to switch back to a man. And sometimes I tend to wonder, would it have been better if the person never had such a drastic change? Because if they didn't have the drastic change, wouldn't they be better off? Because the whole point is, if you change your mind, it's no big deal, you know? Your body has not been modified. You're just you. So, and then, of course, there's a lot of transgender that, because of reasons economics, cannot go that way. That's true. There's a lot of them. And they have a lot of hardships because part of them feels incomplete.
Right.
And those people, when they feel incomplete, the first thing is they say, well, I don't like my physical existence. I don't like who I am. I want to get rid of it. You know, I remember when you were finally medically diagnosed as a hermaphrodite. Even when you were a child before being diagnosed, you kind of felt that way about your body.
Yeah, yes, I did.
But the difference was you were willing to go deeper and ask yourself the probing questions. Like, why am I like this? And that's when, of course, you and I were working, I was your spirit guide then. I was helping Michele to deal with that issue. And in this many videos we've talked about in the past, one of the requirements in Michele's life chart is that this body was designed for two souls to share the body together. It's a compromised body. It works out really well for me. It's works out great for her. Really, it does. I know Michele calls me her, but I don't see that as a reason to get my hackles up in the air. Because I've always known you as a woman. I know. Okay. In my case, once I realized this body was meant for cohabitation, I didn't really have a problem because my body is so feminine anyway. I mean, I have a couple male secondary sex characteristics, but they're so slight you really have to really look to see them. But like I showed you in my shaving demo, I do get... Yes, she does. And I do have to deal with that in the morning. Okay, with the hair in the face. And that's really not the big deal. I've gotten pretty good at it. I know a lot of hair sews that get hair like my growth. And it's not really that bad. Yeah, you can sit there and it's just like with the hair sew. I mean, you can go ahead and spend a lot of money on electrolysis and defoliating creams and all that. But it's not going to change who you are inside. You know... It's almost like the oil of a lake commercial. Love the skin you're in. You need to love yourself. You need to love that you're a creation of God and Mother God. And that everything is okay. And that Mother God and Father God love you regardless of what you do to your body. Of course, remember, this body is only for this time on Earth. And when you're dead, it's meat. Okay, it's not going to be something that's going to last forever. You're not going to take this body with you when you go home. You will be made, you will be returned to your perfectness. And even when Michelle's on life here on Earth, she's trying to kind of let some of that spiritual perfectness on the other side out here. That's why Michelle bleached her hair white. Which grows up really fast. I'm no kidding. Okay. Because Michelle on the other side is a whitehead. Thanks. And you are a brownhead. I'm actually I'm really dark brown hair on the other side. So right now, my root, Michelle's roots, when they're coming out, this is like looking at my head. And this is like looking at Michelle's head. That's kind of an interesting observation because I never really thought about that. It's like when I bleach my hair... Am I bleaching you away? No. Because you get to see my aspect of me every morning. You mean with the facial hair? Yeah, the facial hair. Now, the point I'm trying to say is Michelle has become who she is because she's accepted. And that's not because, out of resignation. She's acceptedly, wholeheartedly, that she's unique. And that's different. And it's okay. So, even if you are transgendered, the first question is can you learn to love the skin you're in? And I'd say, yes, you can learn to love the skin you're in. Does that mean you got to go ahead and chop up your body and do all kinds of surgical and other mutilations to it? Probably not, especially if you're really financially in dire straits. It's not going to happen. Okay, so what happens here is you... have the ability to, realize that you were created by Father and Mother God. You chose, before you came here, to be who you are on this earth. The sad truth is so many people don't realize that. And they get really kind of upset because of that reason. Because they think that God doesn't, that they have no choice. That's it. You are as you are, but did you ever wonder, this is something we talked about the mention a lot, did you ever wonder how you ever came to be the way you are? It's because when you were home on the other side, you came here and you wrote a life chart, and that life chart is how you, and was signed off by Mother and Father God, and you came here to Earth to fulfill your goal may be to be a good, learn to be a good person, to maybe finally perfect being a family person or whatever. Okay, this is a learning classroom. The Earth is a learning classroom. You know what learning means? Life means learning is fundamentally essential. Me and Michelle say that a lot. That's just like it sounds like. Learning is the reason we came here. And when his death didn't advance, this Dad's dead. Didn't advance developmentally. All right. Okay, Dad. Okay. Oh, what would death be? Well, didn't advance this humanity or this hour. That's an interesting twist. Didn't advance this hour. Okay. So the point is that no matter what, you come here to learn, and it's okay. And sometimes the lessons are hard and brutal and cruel, and people can be really nasty. I mentioned that. But, you know, here's the thing that makes it all worthwhile. When your time is through, and you take your last breath before you check out of your body, you realize, as you're looking at the finality of your existence on this earth this time, you start to say, gee, I think I did a pretty good job. Or maybe you might say, gee, you know, I didn't quite get there, but I will come back again and do it right the second time, or third time, or fourth time, or fifth time. How many times have you been on Earth's surface, Michelle?
33.
How many times have you? 32. This is the only one that I combine this journey with you on this in this life. That's true. Yes, that's this. Lumi has been on this 31 times by herself. I've been on this life 32 times by myself. And it's been a wonderful journey. I never had a problem. I love sharing this flesh with you. I really do, because it makes things so much easier. Some ways, I think this is the reason why me and Dory's relationship kind of stagnated. Because Dory knew that I already had a lover. That's true. Dory liked Lumi. Lumi likes Dory. But for some reason, Dory knows that I'm never going to separate from Lumi. Even when we go home, we've already talked about it. We're going to stay together. Because we're twin souls, okay? We're not separating. Once a twin soul combines together, the twin flames join, it means technically it's their final hurrah. They don't have to worry about separating again. But it doesn't mean we can't come back another life. Of course we can. We can come back as much as we want. But the problem is next life is, do you really want to come back on this earth? This planet's getting to be a real mess. Now, you know that. And you're absolutely right. This planet is going to be a terrible mess. Yeah, what are you doing? I'm just checking the phone. You're not seeing any messages? No, you know what? I've been hoping that we've gotten some messages from some people, you know, questions. You know what? Here's the thing. On the Copper Cab video, there's so much confusion about gender and sex. Yes, there is. That's tremendous. I don't understand how it's so hard to understand. Tell me, it's like, oh, this is so simple. Why are you making it sound like it's just complicated? Let me explain to you very simple. I just did, right? When you were born, okay, your essence, your firmware, which your soul, when it enters into your physical presence on Earth, okay, is predominantly a masculine or feminine soul. And that's going to be the seed that's going to grow up to make you the adult person on Earth. It's so simple. Even it's almost impossible to disagree with. The thing that throws people for a loop is the fact is that everybody thinks your soul necessarily matches your genitals. It doesn't. No, it doesn't. I mean, if you're hermaphrodite and you have a feminine soul, then what's your sex supposed to be? I mean, if your sex is hermaphrodite and you have a feminine soul, then what's your gender? It's female. That's right. Okay? If you are born on Earth with a male body, i.e. you have all the male equipment, and yet you act very effeminate, are you male or female? Sexually, you're male, right? Yes, and gender-wise, you're female. The problem is society doesn't like that. Even if you just choose based on the two sexes and the two genders, and there's at least four combinations. Right. You can either be male gender, male sex, female gender, female sex, male gender, female sex, female gender, male sex. That's more than four. I think it's two squared. It's four. Two times two. Two times two. I think it's more than that. I think, yeah, maybe you're right. Okay, so the point is, so you have all these possible choices. Go ahead and write this down on the chart. Just specify between male and female. Genders, male and female sex. Write down every single combination. You'll be surprised what it comes out to be. Huge number. It doesn't come out to no 63. No, it does not. But then we're not talking about androgen male and androgynous male, androgynous female. We're not including hermaphrodite male, hermaphrodite female. We're not including the person's sexual preference. We're not including all that stuff. Just because it would just, it muddies the water. Okay. So now, let's ask this question. Okay? For transgendered people, especially. Can you be physically a happy man and still be a happy female gender? Yes, you can, because you have accepted that you're a man and that you have male organs, but you also have a feminine heart, and it's okay. And so you have learned to embrace and combine the two together. And I'm not talking about the sexual preference thing, because that doesn't even necessarily apply here. Because if you can be a man and like a woman, you can still be a feminine male and still like a woman. Okay, you can be a feminine male and still prefer another man. It doesn't matter. We're just talking about the gender. And likewise, you can be a female and still have male, masculine gender. Right. Same thing, you can be happy with who you are and just want to do man things. And you accept that it's the way it is, and so you don't have a problem with it, okay? The problem is our society is always, this is to the culture business, exactly. They're always trying to change you, which is kind of stupid because it doesn't help. Because you already know who you are inside. Right. And, where are we going to put this video? Huh. Well, your channel has more subscribers than mine does. And it's more likely more people are going to watch it than on my channel. But your channel needs subscribers. You only got 27 of them. And this is perfect material for your channel. So I think we should put it on your channel. Okay, I'll put it on my channel then. And yeah, I agree with you. This should be definitely more material that would probably belong on my channel. Okay, I'll get that statement. Okay, so let's ask this question. What should a parent do if their little boy wants to play with female toys and things like that? I say, let the child do it. Because, like Michelle and I said in unison, it's what the child wants to do. Though maybe the child will grow up eventually more masculine. But please understand that gender, when you start talking about gender and you got the social norms things combined in it, it's really hard to deal with trying to cope, especially when you're growing up. However, should people go through intervene with surgery and hormone replacement therapy? I'm going to have to say that depends on the person. There are some people that, Michelle and I know this, that will just have to accept that things are as they are in. Just try to go with the flow. And it's okay. Michelle is tough. And I know Michelle is tough. And Michelle has grown up having lived in a very poor household. His first few years of her life, which is the most important for formative growth. and Michelle has learned that there are some things that are just are. It's just like the song by Doris Day, que sera, sera. What will be, will be. Exactly. And what will be is that you're just going to become who you are. And those people who sit there and judge another person and say that they're sick or stupid, it's not helping that person at all. It is true that a lot of people who are transgendered are also suffering from a lot of mental issues, such as depression. Depression's real, and it hurts, and it's painful. What could benefit them is a chance to get into therapy and a chance to find someone to help them deal with the latent issues that are really affecting their development. It's not our job, and it isn't our job to try to change a person. It's our job to acknowledge and to understand that this person is a living child of God and the Goddess. So Father and Mother God are their most important thing, and that they created this person by signing off on the life chart in the first place for that person to come here. And it's okay. And if you don't get it right, no one's going to say everybody's perfect. But the hatred is where me and Lumi both agree has got to stop. Did you ever realize, Lumi, that some of that hatred was almost like listening to people like from ISIS? Oh yeah, that was definitely bad. So the fact is that one guy was saying you should kill yourself with bleach. I don't think bleach will kill you. It would certainly make you very sick. Wait a minute. We drink water with bleach in it. It's called chlorine. Yeah, but it's not Clorox. In some cities they use pretty much the same component as Clorox in the chlorination plant. But I agree with you. But the thing I'm trying to say is that those people are almost as bad as ISIS, and they're pushing radical Islamic terrorism and all this. It's really wrong. It's not helpful. No, it's not helpful. And I agree with you. It's terrible. So I suppose that there's some reason why some people likes to push it. But let it be stated right now, me and Michelle will not push that agenda because we do not agree with it. We do not subscribe to it. Thanks. You're welcome. And for those of you who do have honest questions and do want to know more about Michelle or me or both of us, please ask comments in the comment section below and we will do our best to answer them as timely manner as we can. And if you do want to know out of some nastiness and vitriol and you want to be a really horrible person and you don't want to actually listen to anything, save us both a lot of headaches. Just don't even bother sending a message. It'll be promptly deleted or ignored because we don't want to continue to seeing this kind of horrible hate go on in this world. There's enough of it. And if you really hate people that bad, go ahead and join ISIS. Because frankly, as far as I'm concerned, you're just as bad as the jihadists. Amen. Amen. Okay, guys, we're gonna go. So we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye, guys.